Hey, good morning, everybody. 6:45 in the morning. We got a house we're pouring today, probably around 24, 25 yards. Not very good access, so we got a 38-meter boom pump here. So we'll just angle pump it. Should be pretty easy. First truck's just starting to fill in the hopper. Looks pretty good. That looks like. We'll get that all filled in. And we're gonna get going. Did the garage here yesterday just to make today a little bit easier. We could have done both today, but make our life a little easier. He's gonna prime the pump out right there, and then we'll get it over here. Got Harvey helping us here today. They put an additive in the hopper and mix it with water. It's called Slick Willy, and that kind of lubes up the line, so the concrete will go through it without plugging it up. Make sure we get all that Slick Willy out of there. Get all that Slick Willy out. Gotta make sure you get the Slick Willy out, otherwise it doesn't set up very good in the floor. A little windy here today, kind of blowing all the stuff, all the plastic around. Alright, so we got our 3500 PSI floor mix. We got fiber mesh in this. Got a little bit of air in it. Got water reducer so we can pour it nice and loose. Pour about a 7-inch slump here today. And that's our normal floor mix for this stuff. 3500, water reducer, fiber mesh. And then, we can pour it nice and loose. It takes a lot less effort just to get it in. Darren and Luke will stay here today. They'll get this power trial today. They'll get it all sawed today, and we'll be done and out of here today. Probably, I don't know, based off yesterday, I think they got done around 2 yesterday. They'll probably get done about the same time today. The sun doesn't get up over those trees for quite a while now, so this is going to be in the shade quite a bit. Thank you. got a new guy running the pump today, so the guy in the black shirt, he's brand new, they're training him. And he's just trying to learn how to move the boom and not jerk Darren around too bad. So he'll get it. He's a former concrete truck driver, so I mean, he knows how to drive the trucks. It's just a matter of learning how to use the remote with the boom. How you been, Harvey?
Good, how you been, man?
Good. Friday we got a stamp job, Darren tell you?
Yes.
Yeah.
Said you need me there.
It'd be nice.
Yeah.
Then next week we got a house. It's not quite as big as this one, but it's got a whole walkout in front, but they had to move the house on, so we got to boom in through.
Okay.
What day are you available next week, you think?
Anything.
Okay. Because yep. I haven't lined up a pump. I'll call, see what day I can get a pump.
Yep.
Then I'll let you know. I'll do that today.
Okay. Yeah, Jim was gonna. He does need to get a pump over here among those two with some walls.
Next week?
At some
point. Okay.
I don't know when he's gonna call these and get it.
Yep. So when we pump a floor like this, we try to take it in strips, you know, say about 6 feet down, back another 6 feet, back around, down another 6 feet. Try to keep it as square as possible. Our first truck has 8 yards on it. So when we get done, you know, we like to have a square line, as straight a line as possible. That way when we go to finish, when we go to power trial, we kind of know where the first truck was, where the second truck was, third truck. Instead of just dumping it all over the place. And soon as he gets enough pumped out, I can go shoot the pad. Usually we shoot for around 12 to 14 feet out with the pad. A tiny bit low. Let's go throw that bag in that second truck. I'll puddle for these guys. it easy as it is to screed with that screed demon. One guy just needs to be able to give it some throttle, keep the blade pretty flat, and then leave it up to the puddler, you know, to the guy raking the concrete to get it flat. Beginning of fall here now in Maine. It's in September. Temperatures are getting a little chillier, you know. The nights are in the 50s, the days get into the 70s. So we're using, about to use just a little bit of accelerator in the mix. Do you have Tim up there or Scott?
Yeah. Is that dragon plant closure affecting these guys at all?
I don't think it will till next year. I don't think they're closing until next year. Yeah.
I know Auburn said they have other options.
Yeah.
I'm sure.
I'm sure it'll raise the prices quite a bit.
Go along with everything else.
Yep. That first truck never seems to go that far because, number one, it takes about a yard of concrete to fill that whole pump up, and then he does pump a little bit out when he greases the line to begin with. So this second truck, you know, if he goes, that first truck went about 18 feet. This second truck, I think you'll find, probably go like 22, 24 feet. Yeah. It went about 20 feet. Yep. 25 and a half maybe? I can't remember. Should be alright. Your body language is so negative.
I wasn't trying to be.
It's pretty easy using that pump, doesn't it? Pretty much puts it right where you need it, and then with the right swamp, it almost levels it out to where you need it. So that works pretty good. You can see he's gone already about as far as the other one has, and he's still going. Tiny bit more there. Pretty good there. There's a little low on that edge, yeah. Should be almost out. Still a little bit low, Darren. Quarter. Yeah. He's out. You're good, Javi. Go ahead. You're good. That went like twice as far as the first truck, didn't it?
Yeah. Thank you.
Nope. Pressure's on. Everybody's watching. How is it? A little low?
A little low.
We get it?
Nothing.
I know you want to screed. Maybe, yeah. A little bit more, please. That's a homeowner wheelbarrow. We need a contractor. Contractor. Pass you this. Can I pass you that laser too, please? Thank you.
Yes, sir.
Well, I didn't know what we were doing. I'm gonna sweep this in just a tiny bit. What?
You do it with a hand from up top. You probably do it with a hand from up top.
Do what?
The
bike. Oh, straighten it?
Yeah.
You got something you can poke down in it? Pretty easy.
Yeah.
Oh, is that low right there? Probably not. Yeah. See a good wheelbarrow right there, please. Good. Thank you. Good, just for a minute.
Thank you.
Do you have anything else to do with this? Because I imagine we have all you need.
Yeah, it's close. Yep. Take a little bit more, Luke. Another wheelbarrow, please.
Just wanna open her up.
I think there's one coming out of it.
Take a handle off. Nah, we'll come right down to 3 or 4 feet here, then come out with a little one. Yep. I'll jump up. You feel good for a minute there? Looks like punny. Yeah.
Mike, where do you want us to pump out? You want us to put it back into him the best we can? I got a wash out anyway, so I can pump it into him if you guys want.
You don't have to. I mean, he's got an excavator here. What do you want him to do with the...
I mean, I'd like to assume.
What'd they do with the other ones?
Back there where he's working.
You can pull that out. Yep. Thank you, Alan. clutch, straight edge of the bow float. Thinking you might need a bucket or what?
Yeah,
he said he might need a bucket. Can we hold right there just for a minute? If he does, we'll just put it there and I'll just... Actually, you could put a little there right now anyway, then you could just get out of here if you want. Maybe a little more. Another one of those. Alright guys, that's how it's done. That's about 32 feet, this is about 56 feet, 24 yards, dangle pumped, getting in and out of this thing with a ladder. That's about as easy as it is right there. I mean, using that power screed from Screed Demon, MBW, that makes the job so much easier. So now you can see a lot of it's in the shade, it's going to be in the shade for a while. I don't know what time it is, let's see what time it is here. It is 8:13 a.m. Took us just about an hour to do that, so we're gonna just wait probably at least a couple hours. The sun is way over there behind those trees. It's gonna be a while before it gets up there, so it'll be a good day though. It's supposed to be a good warm dry day at least. Thanks for watching guys, we'll see you on the next one.